Have you ever wondered which jet aircraft was the biggest? The results might surprise you. Strap yourself in and discover the top 10 largest passenger aircraft. Hi everyone, and welcome to Fly Marshall, a channel that is focused on everything to do with aviation. We bring you the latest in aviation, from the skies to the terminals and every red eye in between. If you like these videos, don't forget to subscribe and give us a like as we upload new videos weekly. With just a simple click, you can help the YouTube algorithm spread our message far and wide so we can reach more passionate aviators. So, to all our subscribers and viewers so far, thank you! 10. Airbus A330-300. Airbus released this widebody on November 2, 1992. The A330-300 aircraft can carry between 250 to 440 passengers depending on its cabin configuration. In 2020, after passenger traffic collapsed by more than 90%, whereas air cargo demand increased, and Airbus quickly introduced a new cargo conversion solution for its A330, which can handle up to 7.3 tons of cargo in the passenger cabin. 9. Airbus A340-300. The Airbus A340-300 was first manufactured in 1993 and can accommodate 295 passengers in a single-class seat arrangement and 267 in a two-class system. By the end of May 2020, there were just 35 operators of the Airbus A340 left in the world. Lufthansa has 34 aircraft in its fleet and is the biggest A340 operator. Iberia, another major operator which previously had 15 airliners in its fleet, announced their retirement in June 2020. It was affectionately known within the industry as the flying vacuum cleaner, or the aircraft with 5 auxiliary power units, APU, as the main engines look tiny like an APU. 8. Airbus A340-500. The Airbus A340-500 was officially released in 2006, although there were early deliveries in 2002. It is designed for 372 passengers in a single-class seat arrangement and 313 in a double-class system. It was primarily used by Emirates and Singapore Airlines. SIA operated the longest flight in the world from Singapore to Newark on A340-500s until 2013, which has now been replaced by the new and much more efficient A350. It had a massive 16,670-kilometer, 9,000-nautical-mile range and could fly up to 19 hours. Do you love aviation? Then show the world with official FlyMarshall.com gear. Pick your favorites from luggage tags, mugs, t-shirts, hoodies, bath mats, to even pillows. There is so much to choose from, so come check it out now. FlyMarshall.com has everything you need and so much more. Proudly printed in the USA, we offer fast shipping right to your door. Use the discount code HAPPY for 10% off your first order. Links are in the description. 7. Airbus A350-900. The newest jet from Airbus, the A350-900, specializes in long-haul travel with a range of 15,000 kilometers and can accommodate between 300 and 350 passengers. The A350 competes against the Boeing 787-10 and the 777 series, as well as the new Boeing 777X entering service in 2023. By the end of January 2021, the A350 XWB family had received 935 firm orders from 50 customers worldwide, making it one of the most successful wide-body aircraft ever. In 2020 and during the pandemic, the A350 was also converted into cargo aircraft to operate flights carrying large quantities of medical equipment and other urgent supplies. In this configuration, the A350 freighter could carry up to 7.8 tons of cargo. 6. Boeing 777-200. The 777-200 is a passenger plane made by Boeing in the United States. It entered service with United Airlines on June 7, 1995. It can accommodate 440 passengers in a single-class system and 400 in a two-class configuration. As the 777-200 is a slightly older plane, retirements began before the COVID crisis and continued throughout 2020. British Airways, Delta Airlines, and Singapore are among the airlines who are retiring the aircraft type. Five, Airbus A340-600. Introduced in 2002, the A340-600 is the largest capacity member of the Airbus A340 family. The four-engine widebody can carry 380 passengers. As of October 2020, one of the main operators, Lufthansa, recently announced plans to retire the entire fleet. The A340-600 is one of the longest commercial planes ever built, with an impressive length of 75 meters, 250 feet. It was 4 meters, 13 feet, 1.5 inches, longer than the Boeing 747-400, and 2.3 meters, 7 feet, 6.6 inches, longer than the A380. 4. Boeing 777-300. The 777-300 is a passenger plane manufactured by Boeing in the United States. It has a seating capacity of 550 people in a single class and 451 in a two-class configuration, and can travel 6,013 nautical miles, or 11,135 kilometers. Emirates is the largest Boeing 777 operator in the world, with 131 of the 777-300 in service, with Qatar and Cathay Pacific operating 48 each. 3. Boeing 747-400. The 747-400 is a passenger plane made by Boeing in the United States and known to many as the Queen of the Sky. The 747-400 has the capacity to accommodate 416 passengers in a three-class setup, 524 in a two-class setup, and 660 in an all-economy cabin. While the previous 747-300 had two pilots and one flight engineer, the 747-400 automated the flight engineer's tasks. Further structural and electronic improvements were a major development of the 747-400 series. Its inaugural flight was on April 28, 1988, and the 747-400 with Northwest Airlines, NWA. British Airways was formerly one of the main operators, but retired the entire 747 fleet due to the coronavirus crisis in the summer of 2020. 2. Boeing 747-8. The 747-8 is a passenger airplane manufactured in the United States by Boeing. It can accommodate 700 passengers in a single-class system and 600 seats in a double-class configuration. The plane can travel 8,000 nautical miles, or 14,816 kilometers. Since 2020, Boeing has only received 47 orders instead of anticipated 300. Lufthansa was the first one to order 747-8 in 2006. Unfortunately, Boeing has advised customers that the last 747-8 would be assembled and rolled off the assembly line in 2022. In 2017 came the last order for a passenger version of the 747-8, which was for the U.S. President's Air Force One transport plane, due to be delivered in 2024. Boeing plans to replace the 747-8 with the brand new Boeing 777X, which is expected to enter service in 2023. By July 31, 2020, 350 units of the 777Xs were ordered by 8 airlines, including All Nippon Airways, Qatar, and Lufthansa. And the number one biggest passenger plane currently flying is 1. Airbus A380-800. The Airbus A380-800 is a passenger plane made by Airbus in Europe. It has a massive capacity of 853 passengers in a single class, or 644 in a two-tiered class, yet these options are rarely taken. Emirates is currently the main operator of A380 and intends to stay one in the future. Some of its A380s are in a two-class configuration, long range, that has a massive 615 seats. Emirates operates 117 A380s in its fleet, with 5 more pending delivery. It can travel 8,208 nautical miles, or 15,200 kilometers, and first took flight on 27 April 2005. As of 30 September 2020, 242 aircraft have been manufactured, but due to poor sales, Airbus announced A380-800 retirement in 2021. Before the pandemic, the world's fleet of approximately 250 Airbus A380s reportedly made 330 flights per day, with services to more than 70 destinations. It is sad to note that on April 27, 2020, the 15th anniversary of the first A380 flight, just one A380 was up in the air, a lone China Southern flight from Los Angeles to Guangzhou. Some airlines are grounding their A380 fleets for the duration of the pandemic, while others are retiring them. Air France was one of the first to announce the retirement of its entire fleet of A380s. In the summer of 2020, Qantas confirmed that its fleet of 12 Airbus A380s would remain grounded for the next 3 years. Etihad Airways' A380's future is also in doubt since the airline confirmed the grounding of its super jumbos until at least the winter of 2021. Which aircraft have you flown on? What was your favorite? As always, leave your comments below. Remember to hit that like button, and if you're in the airline industry, you're going to want to subscribe. Click that notification bell if you want to be the first to see our regular content.